for maximum mobility and speed.
Does that mean harder checks?
Yes, it does. Introducing the new Warrior Evo QX2 head with Thermalock Plus resin, providing more consistency in all weather conditions.
All I know is this thing rips.
The new Evo QX glove features cloud cuff and hybrid taper fit for maximum mobility and speed.
Does that mean harder checks?
Yes, it does. The Evo QX2 Minimus Carbon Shaft generates a quick release and is fit with signature slide grip.
Sounds fancy.
Built for accuracy, built for consistency, built to win. Just play the game.
Cut. Wrong line, Rob. It's just play the game. Run it again.
Just play the game.
No games with me, I promise I'm too much. Ay, I can never let up even if you had enough. Ay, this ain't for the faint of heart, we always playing rough. I had enough, it ain't luck.
It's on us to stop sexual assault.
To get in the way before it happens.
To get a friend home safe.
And to not blame the victim.
It's on us.
To look out for each other.
To not look the other way.
It's on us to stand up.
To step in.
To take responsibility.
It's on us, all of us,
to stop sexual assault.
Learn how and take the pledge at itsonus.org.
Introducing the new Warrior Evo QX2 head with Thermalock Plus resin, providing more consistency in all weather conditions.
All I know is this thing rips.
Every player knows the skills you learn on the field can be the foundation for anything you choose to do in life.
Thank you for connecting me to a greater community.
We're growing beyond goals on the field.
And our futures are united.
So thank you, Lacrosse.
For inspiring me to be me.
We are better,
safer,
and wiser together.
And we're building a stronger future
for everyone.
The Evo QX2 Minimus Carbon Shaft generates a quick release and is fit with signature slide grip.
Sounds fancy.
The new Evo QX glove features cloud cuff and hybrid taper fit for maximum mobility and speed.
Does that mean harder checks?
Yes, it does. Introducing the new Warrior Evo QX2 head with Thermalock Plus Resin, providing more consistency in all weather conditions.
All I know is this thing rips.
The new Evo QX glove features cloud cuff and hybrid taper fit for maximum mobility and speed.
Does that mean harder checks?
Yes, it does. The Evo QX2 Minimus Carbon Shaft generates a quick release and is fit with signature slide grip.
Sounds fancy.
Built for accuracy, built for consistency, built to win. Just play the game.
Cut! Wrong line, Rob. It's just play the game. Run it again.
Just play the game.
With me, I promise I'm too much. Ay, I can never let up, even if you had enough. Ay, this ain't for the faint of heart. We always playing rough. I had enough. It ain't love.
really surprised that Andrew Gale didn't get any recognition this year. He's up there 15 goals.
Big downfield.
St. Charles, Illinois.
Oh, just a little wide, little wide.
Just finding out Andrew Gale only played 6 games this year. He was hurt the half of the year.
Oh, man. Well, glad to hear he's doing better now because he's making an impact in this game.
18 goals in 6 games.
And that is a shot clock right there. And we're able to clear the ball. Close, though. Ooh. We were a little nervous.
Bad substitution there by Dayton. D. Mitty ends up behind him. Oh, he's able to get the check. All right.
Lucky that worked trail out check for them. Right there. Wow.
That really worked out. That could have cost him.
And Dayton looks cross field. Money pass.
Oof, good handle.
Yeah, very good handle. And this is Jonathan Abarno.
Ooh, look at that cut.
Look how fast this kid is.
Yes.
Finds 44. Ooh, not quite.
Wow, what a hustle. Did you see that one-handed ground ball?
He still has it. Flags are down.
That's Clayton Hamby, senior captain.
Hamby's going to make something happen now. He's got the ball back. Pushing into transition to 45.
Oh, a save.
Holy cow, Hoffman. He's playing out of his mind.
Yeah, he is.
So we've got a push with possession on
that's Jonathan Abarno, yeah.
So that's going to be a 30-second penalty.
He's getting in every category in the stat book today.
Some aren't as good as others, but we'll give it to
him. He scored the last 2 goals.
Yeah, he's doing great right now on that side of things. We've got 6-3, Dayton leading, but the Owls have an opportunity to score on this man up. About 20 seconds left in the man up. They just got to keep it hot.
Kennesaw bench is really calm. Oh, nice.
Sticks up in the passing lane. Excellent job right there by Dayton.
Way to knock it down.
Box, box, box.
Oh, failed, clear, missed pass. You got 6 seconds to clear. Kennesaw's able to get it. Oh, he finds a big hit right on the crease. Oh, flag is down.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, my gosh. Andrew Barner, you animal, you dirty dog. Barner able to eat that up, let them keep playing, and he finds the back of the net there.
Was that number 6?
Yeah, that was. That's Andrew Barner, senior out of Pope High School in Marietta.
Had Tucker Hoffman come out of the net to go get that ground ball. Right, we had a big impact on the crease. Tucker comes out to get it. Andrew is able to snag the ball away from him. Andrew Barner, first team all-conference attackman. He's not going to play that, right? He's going to finish it.
There's going to be a 1-minute illegal body check penalty that Dayton's serving. So they are going to be down 1 right now.
Who's sitting that penalty? Is that Ben Wilch? Yep, looks like that's going to be sophomore defender Ben Wilch for Dayton.
Oh, ball out.
Timeout, Dayton.
Big timeout right there, Dave. Holy cow.
He was just getting rid of it. They called the timeout.
That was called at the right time. Good coaching call right there. Whoa.
Dayton attackman, number 25. Garrett Wolf,
tank.
A beast out there. Freshman, 6'3", 270 from Malvern, New York.
Something in the water in New York.
Not a big points guy this season, but definitely a force out there. He's playing great. I saw him help out on the clear.
Huge handle, one-handed catch.
He did. He handled that. Yeah, that stopped the turnover.
Huge. And now they're going to be able to kill a penalty, or at least they have an opportunity to kill a penalty. These guys look hot. They look a little fatigued.
Kennesaw does not seem rattled, though. Remember, we saw this at our earlier game, St. Thomas and Florida Atlantic. Right, one team can really come out strong and take a three-goal lead and then lose the game by five.
Yeah. Well, this is where you have to ask your seniors to really step up. You say, hey, we've been in this situation before. You know what it's like to come from behind and to pull off a win. And the way you do it is by doing the little things right. You're just consistent about getting those ground balls, finding that extra man, putting it in the back of the net, and taking good shots. But if you start to lose your mind, you lose that composure, you don't even have a chance. So that's where I think you have to ask your leaders to really step up and make something happen.
Absolutely. I think on both teams, both sides, right?
Great
kayak attempt. Way to get out of there by
Barno.
That's Jonathan Abarno, right?
Barno, great job.
He's really been that straw that stirs their drink, huh? Oh, look at that big double. Oh, Abarno calling, looking at the ref, calling for a call, asking for a call, nothing. Oh, what a check on the other side. Perfectly timed.
Perfect.
Robbie Siegfring, senior defender, causes the turnover.
Holy cow.
These senior captains just stepping up. They just did for Dayton.
Telling you, they have to.
End of the quarter. We are at halftime, folks. Game is a two-goal rout here. It's 6-4 Dayton.
The skills you learn on the field can be the foundation for anything you choose to do in life.
Thank you for connecting me to a greater community.
We're growing beyond goals on the field.
And our futures are united.
So thank you, Lacrosse.
For inspiring me to be me.
We are better,
safer,
and wiser together.
And we're building a stronger future
for everyone.
The Evo QX2 Minimus Carbon Shaft generates a quick release and is fit with signature slide grip.
Sounds fancy.
The new Evo QX glove features cloud cuff and hybrid taper fit for maximum mobility and speed.
Does that mean harder checks?
Yes, it does. Introducing the new Warrior Evo QX2 head with Thermalock Plus resin, providing more consistency in all weather conditions.
All I know is this thing rips.
The new Evo QX glove features cloud cuff and hybrid taper fit for maximum mobility and speed.
Does that mean harder checks?
Yes, it does. The Evo QX2 Minimus Carbon Shaft generates a quick release and is fit with signature slide grip.
Sounds fancy.
Built for accuracy, built for consistency, built to win. Just play the game.
Cut. Wrong line, Rob. It's just play the game. Run it again.
Just play the game. Thank you.
far, they hated, they never believe me. Yeah, I would never drop the ball, I know I make it look easy. Yeah, Mayweather with the defense. I don't care what a critic got to say, I got them picking up the pieces. Hey, please don't play no games with me, I promise I'm too much. Hey, I can never let up even if you had enough. Hey, this ain't for the faint of heart, we always playing rough. I had enough, it ain't love.
It's on us to stop sexual assault.
To get in the way before it happens.
To get a friend home safe.
And to not blame the victim.
It's on us.
To look out for each other.
To not look the other way.
It's on us to stand up.
To step in.
To take responsibility.
It's on us, all of us.
To stop sexual assault.
Learn how and take the pledge at itsonus.org.
Introducing the new Warrior Evo QX2 head with Thermalock Plus Resin, providing more consistency in all weather conditions.
All I know is this thing rips.
Every player knows the skills you learn on the field can be the foundation for anything you choose to do in life.
Thank you for connecting me to a greater community.
We're growing beyond goals on the field.
And our futures are united.
So thank you, Lacrosse.
For inspiring me to be me.
We are better,
safer,
and wiser together.
And we're building a stronger future
for everyone.
The Evo QX2 Minimus Carbon Shaft generates a quick release and is fit with signature slide grip.
Sounds fancy.
The new Evo QX glove features cloud cuff and hybrid taper fit for maximum mobility and speed.
Does that mean harder checks?
Yes, it does. Introducing the new Warrior Evo QX2 head with Thermalock Plus Resin, providing more consistency in all weather conditions.
All I know is this thing rips.
The new Evo QX glove features cloud cuff and hybrid taper fit for maximum mobility and speed.
Does that mean harder checks?
Yes, it does. The Evo QX2 Minimus Carbon Shaft generates a quick release and is fit with signature slide grip.
Sounds fancy.
Built for accuracy, built for consistency, built to win. Just play the game.
Cut. Wrong line, Rob. It's just play the game. Run it again.
Just play the game.
Never drop the ball, I know I make it look easy. Yeah,
Mayweather with the defense. I don't care what a critic got to say, I got him picking up the pieces. Hey, please don't play no games with me, I promise I'm too much. Hey, I can never let up even if you had enough. Hey, this ain't for the faint of heart, we always playing rough. I had enough, it ain't luck.
It's on us to stop sexual assault.
To get in the way before it happens.
To get a friend home safe.
And to not blame the victim.
It's on us.
To look out for each other.
To not look the other way.
It's on us to stand up.
To step in.
To take responsibility.
It's on us, all of us,
to stop sexual assault.
Learn how and take the pledge at itsonus.org.
Lacrosse fans, welcome back to Round Rock, Texas. We've got our first round of the MCLA National Tournament. We've got the Kennesaw State Owls versus the Dayton Flyers. Right now we've got Dayton leading 6-4. I see someone in the box for the Flyers right now. And Dave, is that going to cause them an issue starting off the second half?
Is that the case? I don't remember a penalty carrying over, but I suppose is that going to mean that they're going to get possession? Do you remember if they retain possession at halftime?
No, we probably should have been paying more attention, I guess.
Yeah, I guess so. Well, I was just thinking that, you know, Kennesaw, they're down by two here. Yeah, it looks like.
He's sitting on the wing here. Don't worry, we'll bring everyone right back up to speed. We don't have the instant replay to see the last 10 seconds of the first half.
Kennesaw State is used to playing tough competition. They're down by two. This is a pretty familiar area for them. This season, they played five teams in the top 25, and they went 3-2. Those two losses were by one goal.
Oh, so Dayton was getting double-teamed, and they were able to keep the ball. So 74 seconds on the shot clock. Really, what has to happen is this number 32 needs to take away the left side even more. They did the exact same thing.
Oh, he just got through the swim.
He didn't stop anything there, which just blows me away. Well, that's a big body right there. That's Alton Albright right there, not having any issue.
They're even now. Dayton's just released.
Now the ball's with Matt Cesario. Oh, big righty shot.
Ooh, oh, what a rip that was.
Barely missed that one.
And that's out in the parking lot.
Wow, that almost hit my car. Just kidding. I hit it behind the trucks.
He put a lot of steam behind that one.
All right, ball's behind right now. We can't see who it is, but we'll let you know.
Got Cesaro again.
Yep. Cesario's got it. Oh, great check right there by the Owls. Uh-oh. Out of bounds.
20 seconds in the...
Not out of bounds.
Shot clock. Running downfield.
Shot by number 10. Sails it. That was Nick Karius. 16 seconds on the shot clock.
Oh, Nick Karius coming off. Holding the side, might have taken a check right to the ribs or something.
Oh, great D. Oh, but the referees didn't agree.
Oh, good skip pass to find Cesario.
Oh,
good big double. Cesario
right
got through, goal.
And he finds the back of the net. Give it to your captain and let him make something happen. Big play right there by Matthew.
Matt Cesario continuing what he did all season. That's his second goal of the game, his 29th on the year.
Woo! That kid can play ball.
Big goal scorer.
They're giving it a push in the back, waved off. So we've got 6-on-6 play, pushed forward by the Owls, number 27.
Oh, what a feed.
Oh, my gosh, 17. So that was
17
Andrew
six.
Barner to Chase Campbell. Just disgusting. Those guys both need to go to jail because that was a robbery.
Yes, that's Jason Campbell got that ball on the crease, made a dodge, low, went high. Masterful work. That's his 25th goal of the year. Nope, 27th goal. It's his third goal of the game.
Incredible. Really incredible to see. Really, and we get a nice face-off win right there by the Owls, and they're able to settle things down. We've got the ball at the top left right now with Andrew Barner looking to make some more things happen as well. Brandon Nolly gets the ball down to X. Chase. I'm going to call him Chase. I don't know him that well, but I'm just going to take a guess right here. All right, here's Nolly. Nolly, puts it in his left, gets back to the middle, finds Jack, gets it banged over. One more. Big Jack stepping up with a little hitch.
Oh, great lift.
Huge lift right
by
there.
By Dayton defender Ben Wilch.
Oh, and Jack's still in it. He picks it up. It's out, still on the ground.
Great aggressive defense here.
20 seconds on the shot clock. You got to recognize 20
broken
seconds.
Stick by number 36,
and
Dayton's defender.
That's going out.
J.P. Brar. Stick fell apart on him. Senior defender probably needs a screw in that stick. Looks like the head just popped off.
Uh-oh. I remember my junior year at Arizona State University. We had a practice where Coach Chris Malone went and did a stick check of every single person's stick. And we ended up having to do 10 suicides because 10 kids' sticks didn't have screws or this or that.
Wow.
And that was the most brutal thing in the world. But it's those little things. You need to make sure your stick's ready.
Oh, what a shot. That Ripper was by Ted Laritz.
Laritz with a huge righty rip.
Freshman attack, 6'6", 200 pounds from St. Louis,
huge.
Missouri. It's his second goal of the game.
Are we giving someone an assist on that one?
Yeah, that should be an assist.
Yeah, that was from 21. That was Jonathan Abarno. Abarno's all over the place right now. Beautiful. Dave, who were you saying was the specialty?
44 had one earlier.
Easy face-off win right there by Kennesaw State. 27, Mitch Taylor.
Right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, the sixth goal is 44.
So we've got the Owls getting the ball back, looking to quell this lead and bring things back to a little bit closer. We've got 8-5 right now, 11:26 left in the third quarter. A little shake and bake action right there. Oh, not able to get much right there is Brian Kemp, but he maintains possession, which is really critical. Ball goes high, gets behind to Polanski, and we've got an inside little move right there. Oh, couldn't execute. Shot.
Oh, big shot, big save.
Save by Hoffman. Is that Hoffman's sixth on the game?
That's what I've got, but I don't know if that's right. I might have missed a few. I'm not sure.
Well, we'll
check.
Oh,
when we can.
I love that little can opener right there. Great defense by number 54 for Kennesaw. That's Justin Martin. Love to see it. Is Justin Martin the freshman? Yeah, he's the 6'1 freshman. That's definitely bigger than 6'1.
Yep. He's having a great game today. Brendan Nolly on the clear.
Owls able to get the clear, take their time. They're at 60 seconds on the shot clock.
10 minutes in the quarter.
trailing by three. We got to see something happen. Hey, Dave, who was the specialty player of the year?
That's the faceoff guy for Kennesaw State, Mitch Taylor.
Oh, yeah, Mitch has just been dominating.
Yeah, number
last
27.
Three faceoffs.
Yeah.
We need to see more from him. Oh, inside look. Couldn't execute.
Right on his tail.
We love that. That's intensity.
Oh, you better get rid of that ball.
Inside look.
Oh, what a
feed. 2-43. Wow. Dylan Polanski to Jack McLaughlin. Absolutely beautiful right there. That's the Ackworth to Ackworth connection. Unfortunately, they're not from the same school, but really, really cool right there. 2-43. Now this is where we ask Mitch Taylor to step up. We say, hey, Mitch, we really need this right now. We need some make it take a lacrosse to bring this down below two goals. What you got, man? What you got?
Ben Hadley, the Dayton D-Mitty faceoff. He's still in this.
Great contested
had a
ground
great,
ball right there.
He had a great chance there.
Excellent GB right there. Excellent. These guys are hustling. It's so much fun to see.
Two-goal game now. Dayton up 8-6. Kennesaw with possession looking to make this a one-goal game.
They've got an opportunity. They've got their starting midfield line out here.
I think they've just been sticking to their game plan.
I think Jack's tired. I think Big Jack's tired. He just did a shake-off right there. Or he had the pull on him.
Oh, good double.
Great.
Wow. Toss it away.
That's a fantastic ride right there.
Yeah.
The Owls really want to win. Yeah, they're tired.
Nick,
these guys are tired.
Nick Karras with
Big Jack needs one too. He's asking for a breath. He's saying, Coach, I need it. I'm tired. It's hot. We've got 8:43.
Whew. Wow.
Oh, that
looked
a
like
hold,
a hold. Yeah.
Yep. Laundry down. Get the ball over to Jack. Jack goes, yup.
That's another hold. I'm not going to call that one, though. Oh, good skip pat. Not able to wrangle it.
That's a tough pass right there. Well, now.
That's a good play by Kennesaw.
Yeah, Kennesaw has the extra man opportunity. I think we're going to see a little bit of rotation and get Big Jack. Big Jack Ginley with the shot. That's my prediction right now. What do you think, Dave?
I think it's really hard to say with a team like this. They've got a lot of weapons. But Dayton's been in this situation before. They've got a lot of really close games this year. Two goals, three goal games against top 25 opponents.
Oh, my gosh. Dayton.
Yep.
That's the energy you have to bring. If you can do extra pressure right at the start of a man down, you're going to be able to create enough havoc where you can get a turnover.
You're right.
Because if you let a man down take time, I feel like that's where you get fatigued, you get out of place. If you can jump it right away, it's beautiful.
Yeah, you asked me a question about how confident I was in the Kennesaw State man up there. And I really couldn't speak on it, right?
Was that why?
Dayton is, they are just a really good defensive team.
Yeah, Dayton number six with the ball.
Man down, they were able to get take possession, clear it. Now they have possession of the ball on the offense. Penalty is released, they are all even. 30 seconds left on the shot clock.
Inside look, pass and finish. That was number 9-19. Andrew Gale with the assist is Jake Meyer, captain. Jake did an excellent job of getting inside and finding Andrew Galley with a nice goal.
All right, Grandpa!
That's Galley's second of the day. And the second assist for Jake Meyer.
Galley's 17th on the season.
And they extend
great
their lead by
win,
to
right?
three again. Yeah.
Ben Hadley's been having himself a day against one of the best face-off guys in the MCLA. Top 10, for sure. Top 5, even.
Oh, we got to have our short stick lock off 21.
Yeah.
You got to get some pull-on-pull action right there. we've got the big LSM for Kennesaw, who should just eat and just eat them up.
Barno now with the ball. Barno's been a big part of Dayton's offense. Oh, loose ball at X. Dayton somehow able to come up with it. I'd probably call a timeout here. Not able to wrangle that. LSM all on his own, fighting two Dayton Flyers. He's able to get it and clear the ball.
Ooh, baby.
What a stud. Look at this guy. Oh, ball's loose.
He's exhausted.
Yeah, he is. Oh, his teammate's able to bail him out. Kennesaw number six with a huge GB. That's Andrew Barner. Call a timeout.
Timeout. Owls.
Woof.
That was a nice call right there. Shout out to Justin Martin right there, pushing the ball. We love to see the LSM transition right there. And then a really nice handle by number six. That's Andrew Barner, senior from Marietta. Has composure, picks up a ball, make sure that his team gets the possession so that they have an opportunity with 6 minutes left in the third quarter to find the back of the net. We're gonna go for a quick commercial and be back after the break.
Every player knows the skills you learn on the field can be the foundation for anything you choose to do in life.
Thank you for connecting me to a greater community.
We're growing beyond goals on the field.
And our futures are united.
So thank you, Lacrosse.
For inspiring me to be me.
We are better,
safer,
and wiser together.
And we're building a stronger future
for everyone.
Welcome back, Lacrosse fans. This is Ryan Burns and Dave Leach, and we are so excited to be doing some commentary for the MCLA National Tournament here in Round Rock, Texas. We've got Dayton leading 9 over Kennesaw State with 6. Ultimately, we're gonna see what these Owls can do. They've got possession in the top or side right of the box, and they're looking to find the back of the net here. We got 6:08, 62 seconds on the shot clock. We saw a great defensive effort right there from the Owls.
Justin Martin, freshman defender, really playing LSM for the Owls today. 6'1", 205, second on his team in GBs, has really just been making play after play for his team.
Oh, yeah.
Got a lot of award winners on this Kennesaw State team, but Justin Martin was not one of them. He somehow was overlooked this season. I don't think that's going to be for long. He's really making his name known here in this tournament.
Oh.
Big turnover.
Oh, that's
Dayton running for daylight. He's got a double team on him. Oh, that's the worst thing that could happen there.
Oh,
a turnover
again
to the middle of the field.
And then a flag. And then
Andrew Barner is able to get the ground ball, retain possession, draws the flag, beats two, and buries it.
He does it!
Wow.
He does it! Oh, my gosh. Andrew Barner. Senior. We've been saying that name
senior,
a lot.
Senior, first team all-conference player.
I believe it.
Just owned that play from top to bottom.
Wow. That's his second of the day, and I don't think that's going to be his last.
Oh, no, he's not done.
It can't be his last.
That's his third of the day, actually.
Oh, I missed one of his goals then.
His fourth. That is his actually fourth goal. Yeah, we're not stat people. Yep, but I have been keeping notes, and it's just a little messy. That's his fourth goal.
That's incredible. The kid's on fire. Oh, and that's a huge
two-goal
win right
game now.
Taylor.
Big face-off win.
Needed that one.
Mitch Taylor got the best of Ben Hadley on that one.
Big Jack Kinley.
Ben really playing out of his mind today. He went 97 and 98 on the season.
Holy cow.
Meanwhile, Mitch.
You're going to do that on your man-up attempt? We don't like that.
Meanwhile, Mitch Taylor won 176 and 75.
Holy cow. So we need to see everyone lock off right now.
Yeah.
Joe Lill needs to say, hey, step up. Everyone needs to lock off. Lock off. Lock off. How do you get open?
The pole got
oh no.
Pulled a little trick there, I think.
And we had a slide up field because you didn't match up right. That is devastating. Oh, they got lucky there, Dave. Lucky there. Okay. 28 for Dayton. Cesario has the ball.
All even now.
And Matt is just ready to go. He's going. He's looking inside. Takes the pressure. Holy cow. That guy's an animal.
He is.
That guy's an animal.
Matt Cesario showing his dominance again.
Oh, my goodness.
His third of the game.
That's incredible.
Do you have an assist on that?
No, that's unassisted.
Okay.
He said, hey, I'm stronger than you. I'm going to run around, and I'm going to find the back of the net. And that's what he did.
He is not done.
Boys are buzzing on the sideline. They're ready to go.
Oh, Mitch Taylor with a huge plunge and pop. Andrew. Big, what a feed. Oh!
What about that tic-tac-toe, baby?
Wow. Four players involved in that play.
That is incredible.
Bang, bang, bang. Perfect fast break.
Bang,
slow
bang,
break play.
Bang.
I don't even know. That's just
beautiful. What was ball
that? Who
was
that? Nine on the assist?
That shows you it's just one step, and then the whole defense is rotating.
Was that?
Oh, wow.
And a penalty.
And one.
Who got that goal? Was that two?
Who do we get on that goal?
Okay.
17-2 right there.
Yep.
Incredible. So big shout out right now to Dylan Polanski for a jump in the air to the pass from Chase Campbell. Really, really nice. We'd love to see that.
Two with a goal and assist now for Polanski. We got a two-goal game. 3:50 remaining in the third. Dayton is up 10-8.
One more. Oh.
It's staying in?
The Owls are having the worst time on EMO.
The double team. Yep, not able to get through it. Ball is down.
Loose ball push. That's going to be white ball. Staying with the Owls. Step down. Oh.
Oof.
Oh my gosh, I would not have
probably taken
that one. Yeah.
That's a pretty decent shot, though.
I thought no angle.
It didn't look it, yeah.
Yeah. That thing was hard and really close.
Narrowly missed it. There's Big Jack. Save.
He went mid to mid.
He did.
Just a sidearm mid to mid. You can't score like that. It's ridiculous. Come on, change the plane of your shot. Oh no, that's a bad turnover right there.
Yeah, a little jumpy. I mean, they got to be gassed.
Oh, I think so. They've got 3 minutes left in this third. That's what we were talking about, that fast pace at the start. It's going to be legs. It's going to be the depth. Shot, 43. Popcorn!
What a save.
I'm a little upset, though, that no Dayton player was running upfield for a fast break. Yeah.
They're wearing the dark uniforms. It's got to be hot out there.
Nick Karras.
Oh. Good shot. Good save.
Huge save. Oh, here we go.
Oh, see right there? That was a good
Chance
clear.
Chance Foster.
Not able to handle it. Oh, huge hit. Wow. Jonathan Abarno just got rocked at midfield. Dayton's saying that that's a high hit. Chance Foster hit him there. Chance is definitely smaller. Yeah, okay, so they're calling that as a clean hit. No penalty.
And it looks like Clayton Hambry's looking to clear the ball over the midfield.
Ooh. Dayton's got a good ride. But Paul's able to get behind him.
And now we've got 55 on the shot clock.
It's a great clear. Mitty really helped clog up the middle and got that pole free. Made it an easy clear.
There's your senior captain doing what's needed right now. Showing up big.
2 minutes left in the third. Oh, those bounce passes are tough, man.
They're really tricky. I've said it from the start. Bounce passes are hard to handle. Oh, I love that little pick and roll.
Boom!
Oh, sailed a little high. Clayton Hambry, beautiful setup right there. That's a great two-man game. And they're doing some more two-man games behind. Oh, Andrew didn't have that one. 12 seconds on the shot clock, 11 seconds on the shot clock. They got to do something quick, Dave. What are they going to do? This is Hambry. Hamby. Yep. Inside shot. Did that hit the goalie? Reset.
Not able to
get a reset. Past it. And now it looks like Dayton's going to have an easy clear. Oh, pull and pull action.
Tricky clear there.
Oh, jeez, look at Abarno. He is just athletic, cutting in and out. For the young folks watching, that's when we talk about a V-cut. That's what we want to see.
Yeah, it's explosive.
Explosive. You lose your defender that way. And that's what you have to do. If your offense is going to score, you have to be able to find an opportunity by losing your defenseman. Good little inside cut there, clearing away. Let him take the right alley. And this is Shanahan.
20! 20!
Shanahan's just staying behind Pat, freshman out of Buffalo, New York. Oh, nice little pick there.
10 seconds.
Got the pull on him.
Oh, good skip pass.
Oh, my gosh.
Abarno.
Underhand skip. He did an underhand skip pass there. That's silly.
5 seconds. Oh. What happened there? Did he hit the defender?
They threw his stick on. You can't throw a stick on. And Dayton found the back of the net.
I think it went off the defender's stick and into the net.
We missed the goal right there.
Mayhem.
I think that's 44.
Who scored?
Defender. It went in, right?
Shanahan. So, who scored?
That was 44 off a defender, right?
Loretz.
43 off of 44. Okay.
Okay. Ted Loretz, number 44, with the goal.
Crazy goal.
With literally a second to go. And that wraps up our third quarter. Lacrosse fans, thank you so much for watching. We will be back after a quick commercial. Maybe a quick commercial.
Even if you had enough, ay, this ain't for the faint of heart. We always playing rough. No, I had enough. It ain't love.
Welcome back, lacrosse fans. We've got a battle right now with the number 9 and number 8 teams, Dayton, as well as Kennesaw State. Dayton's leading 11-8. 15 minutes of lacrosse play, and I'm just overwhelmed. This is Ryan Burns, and I'm joined by Dave Leach. Dave, How are you feeling about this game right now?
I'm impressed. I really didn't think that Dayton had it in them to hold this kind of, you know, pressure on the gas pedal the whole game, but they've done it. I don't think they're really at risk at all here going into the fourth quarter. It's a testament to where they are as a program. This year they took on 9 top 25 opponents. They went 4-5. 3 of those losses were by 2 goals or less. They have been playing top flight opponents all season and holding their own. And they're showing it again. It's really paying off here in the first round of the tournament. And I suspect they'll finish this, but we'll see if the specialty player of the year, Mitch Taylor of Kennesaw State, can change that here with this first faceoff. Ball is up.
You've got to play 60 minutes of lacrosse.
Here we go.
That's the thing. Can you finish this game? And Dayton with a good stop right there. Looks inside number 9.
Oh, what a save.
Oh, my gosh. Dominic with a massive save right there. That's crazy.
McJack.
Here's our boy Martin. Wheeling and dealing.
McJack was the
double coming
tournament defensive player on the all-tournament team.
Oh, look at that. There's our bounce pass. Inside, one more pass.
Well, goalie's able to
wrapped up by Hoffman. And that's going to be a clear for Dayton, the Flyers. Connor Casey with the ball. We've got under 60 seconds. They're going to call a ward on Carson Merle.
You don't see that all the time.
Oh, but they can't make the pass.
Might be the only ward call we see all week.
I was going to say ball doesn't lie. Good GP
there.
Oh,
big double. Great checks.
Uh-oh. We got numbers. Numbers for Dayton.
I'd call this timeout if I was Dayton.
I think they had numbers.
No way, man. Look at all the defenders there. He had 3 guys on him that time.
They got there quick. These guys are athletic.
Yeah.
Jack Ray with the ball right now. I just feel like it's still anyone's game. I know Dayton has the 3-point lead, but
I
have this funny feeling about what's happening.
13 minutes remaining. Oh, great play by Big Jack.
Big Jack.
Oh, he gets dropped there in the middle. Dayton's ball again.
Yeah, nice trail check right there.
Casey Connor with the ball. He's got 7 goals this year as a freshman.
Here's Carson. Carson's still dodging.
Double. Oh, he's got double.
Coma slide. Gets into the backside.
Able to get out of there.
Oh, one more.
Great shot. Way to withstand that pressure. Andrew Gale took a big hit from Jack Guiney. Still able to get the shot off. Went wide, but possession. 46 seconds on the shot clock. Got 12:14 remaining in the fourth.
Looks like Dayton has the ball back down with number 12, Jack Ray. Jack gets topside. Brings the ball around.
Way to withstand that pressure from Kennesaw.
Huge. Over Ted.
I think the Owls are feeling the pressure now. Oh, flat-footed.
Topside.
Great
goal.
Save.
43, Kyle Collett. Cincinnati, Ohio, Lakota East. Wow, Kyle.
Oof. Turnover at midfield. See if you can get this ground ball.
Is that a save? Did I miss that one?
Yeah, that was a save there.
That's huge. I thought I saw it go in the back of the net.
No.
I'm seeing things. It's hot out here. Yeah, Dayton's just killing clock right now.
I got 7 saves for Kennesaw's goalie. Dominic McJack.
This is Captain Matt. Big shot. Now, that one is in the back of the net. That's Captain Matt Cesario tallying his, gosh, is that his fifth? Fourth of the day. Incredible.
That's a good performance on your first game of the tournament.
Yeah.
You're getting the job done. This is your goal. Right, it's one thing to make the tournament. It's another thing to win a game. Because at this point, at a 200 teams, we're down to the last 16.
Yeah.
Right, it's top talent. Top coaching.
Excuse me. 10:45 left in this game.
Kennesaw is a heck of a program. Really great team. A lot of firepower. They're in their second year with this head coach. Right? Dayton is on their 10th year with their head coach and their assistant coach.
Oh, nice.
Great shot.
Nice.
Great finish.
That's a pass from Chazin to Andrew.
Six. Andrew Barner.
Andrew Barner finds the net again. And that was a pass from Campbell, 17.
Campbell's got four goals and one assist today. Barner's got five goals. Those two guys are really stepping up for Kennesaw.
They have to.
Mitch Taylor on the faceoff now. New Dayton faceoff guy. That's Garrett Wolf.
Oh, my gosh.
That would be his first faceoff. Nope, that's 26. That's Alton Albright. He's 16-8 on the faceoff. He just won another faceoff.
The kid's a stud.
Against Mitch Taylor.
Look at
that. My goodness. Alton Albright does it all. He fights for the ground ball. Doesn't let the defender, or the faceoff guy, win it so easily. 6'3", 235.
The
moves like
stud.
He's half that weight.
The kid's a
flies
stud.
Down the field, buries it. Makes it a four-goal game for Dayton.
You see Mitch Taylor go so fast, and Albright says, I don't care. I'm going to trail check, get the ball, and run coast to coast, essentially, and put in the back of the net.
Mitch Taylor out for this one. This is Adam Pijak. He's gone 11-7 this year on faceoffs.
Great faceoff.
There we go,
right
12-7 now.
A little goose action.
Yep. Albright, go! He's able to beat Albright on that faceoff. Right? Kind of surprising they asked Albright to do two back-to-back faceoffs after he just scored that.
Hey, the boy earned it. If he wants to do another, if the kid wants another, I'll give it to him.
Yeah.
That's what we like. We say, hey, catch your breath. I want you back in. I want you getting as many reps as we can. 9:45 left in the match. Ball's behind with number two, Dylan Polanski. Ooh.
Oh, good double. Oh, D twigs him. That's Robbie Seifering and Ben Wilch teaming up on that double team. Ball still on the ground. Kennesaw somehow able to get it. Ball is still on the ground again. Oh, big hits.
Holy cow, there was a lot of bodies on the floor there.
Yeah, I'd be feeling those collisions if that was me. Dylan Polanski limps off the field.
Cramps.
Looks like he's got a cramp. They're calling for a trainer and his coaches.
That's the worst thing in the world.
Stretching him right there in the sub box.
We gotta give a shout out actually to Jaden. He's their
trainer's there to help him.
These guys are giving all they got right now. And sometimes that's just what you have.
Ooh, good double.
56, moving it. 36 shot, hit a defenseman.
Someone soaked that up.
Oh, my gosh, and he's wheeling. Wheeling and dealing.
Ben Welsh having a great game today. Comes up with that ground ball and clears it. Dayton is just flying on these defensive subs, or on these defensive slides. And Kennesaw is trying to get him with the skip pass, right? If you've got a double on one side of the field, you hit the backside. And Dayton's there. Great individual play.
Ben Welch with some composure on that clear, just waiting. Killing time, letting his offensive unit get on the field. And we've got 8 minutes left to play.
Ben's second on his team in ground balls this season. Sophomore defender from Powell, Ohio.
Oh, that's nothing.
It's been clutch, right?
Yep, that was interference.
Yep. Oh, bad shot. We got a flag down.
Yep, another EMO.
8 minutes remaining.
They blasted that pick, guy. You can't do that. You got to respect the pick. We've got Dayton with an extra man opportunity. We've seen them stop a lot of fast break, We've seen them stop a lot of man ups. Let's see how they can do on their own. So it's going to be Ted's starting with the ball. Gets it up to Abarno down behind. Good ball movement so far. Back to Lawrence, Abarno. Over to Cesario.
Oh.
Ted, ball on the ground.
Bad flip pass between
Abarno
and Laritz. Kennesaw able to get the clear man down. Is that Jonathan Martin?
It is.
Justin Martin?
It's our boy. It's our boy Martin. Oh, and he just lost it.
Well, he's getting double teamed. That was a heck of a play. Look at him get back into the play, though.
Oh, no look pass shot.
Oh, great
save. Holy cow. These guys are gassed. Look at these guys.
Yeah.
Everyone's hands on their knees. They're going, I can't believe there's 7 minutes left in this game. I'm fatigued. That's the hard thing about this. 8 seconds left. Oh, Abarno's just nasty.
Oh, way to eat that up. Kennesaw
left,
number 12.
Oh,
Michael Roman.
Check. Roman with another big
just
check there.
Soaked up that shot. Wow, what a hustle.
Look at that hustle right there. By number 9, Andrew Galley. And it's staying with Dayton. Wow.
Andrew Galley with a huge hustle play, back to back. Gets up on his feet, chases it down. Ted Larrett's coming out for a sub.
And they've got 60 seconds on the shot clock. They can get a whole D unit switch.
Nick Harris on the field. Abarno coming off the field.
And Kennesaw has been down the entire time. They've been man down, almost got a stop.
Alton Albright with the ball, the ISO up top.
Now they're going 6-on-6.
Cesario, the two big men.
This is a tough stand.
These guys
right
could be
here.
Twins.
Yeah.
26 and 28. Big boys.
Who says they're not?
Oof. Probably
stay
their mothers.
Probably. Probably. 6-10 left in this match. Dayton looking strong right here with the ball behind in 43. Gets it over to 10. Banging the ball around. Look at Albright with the big pick.
Yeah.
Couldn't find him back on the inside, though, with the pick and roll. And now Owls getting the ball.
Good smart move. Get the ball into the outside. One over, one up. Look at that up pass. There it is.
That's
not
a tough
quite
one.
Able. Jonathan. Oh, ball still down. Dayton defender.
He got to be able to clear
Robbie
the ball.
Seifering scoops it. Albright. Clears it. He's trying to get his stick. I think the referee can help him here now.
And that's going to be a
Dayton goal. You see who got that one? Number 28, Cesario with another goal.
Goal for Cesario.
That's his fifth goal of the game.
The guy's on fire. His cleats are really hot because the ground's so hot, but unassisted goal, Cesario. That's your senior captain doing what a senior captain should do.
All three Kennesaw players just walked off the field. These guys are done.
Hadley with a big face-off win right there.
Dayton, this is a lot of fun to watch them, huh?
They're looking good.
They're a high-powered offense. Every single one of those guys, the top six.
Okay, let's see what the Owls can do.
Look at the hustle by Abarno. Wow.
He goes straight to the backside, smart. Too.
I wish I could hustle like that.
Yeah.
That's impressive.
I don't think I ever could.
Wow. Wow, look at that. Great defensive play. Good stop.
It's a stop.
That's his 10th save of the game.
We love to see it.
Dayton wastes no time.
Flyers looking good out here. 4:20 left.
5-goal lead for the Dayton Flyers. Remember, this is a team that in 2019 lost the final.
Shot. No goal, and that's going to be a late hit.
Lost the championship final to St. Thomas 7-9.
Tough.
Since COVID, they've been looking to get back there. During the COVID year when it got shut down, 2020, March 8th, they shut it down. They were 5-1. Last year went 6-3 and did not qualify for Nationals. Losing to Duluth. Minnesota Duluth 15-12 last season. This season lost the championship, the conference championship to St. Thomas.
Oh.
And I think that's put a chip on their shoulder. They know they can play, they can know they can compete.
It looks like it. Illegal body check on number 22, Tony Nguyen. That'll be a 1-minute penalty. Dayton has the opportunity to just kill 60 seconds. But they look inside instead and take a shot. Hit the goalie, keep on moving the ball though. Great ball movement, looking again for it. 21 shot, Ibarra
put everything he had behind that one.
He really did. He just torqued, you know, a little bit too much.
I don't blame him for continuing to shoot, right? It's a man-up opportunity.
Yeah.
You need to get this man-up dialed in this tournament. Like a nice flip pass on a man-up play.
They've been doing that little fake a bunch. That's their play.
I like it.
They get two guys cutting across the top right there. One guy coming. Sometimes they keep it. Sometimes they pass it.
Right. You know the man down is going to be in a zone, so get in those seams.
You have to. You have to find them. And you have to really extend. I think that's why it's important to hit the corners.
Oh, look at that ball movement. He's able to knock it down. Not sure who that was. Kennesaw defender had the stick up. Oh, Dayton's still able to get it.
Oh. Needs to tie his shoe.
.323 remains. 5-goal lead for Dayton.
We've got 10 seconds in the penalty, it sounds like. Maybe see if you get something quick, and if not. Oh, bad turnover. Just can't handle it right there.
Yeah. You know, Barno had a lot of pressure on him there. These Kennesaw D-middies, they're no joke.
No, you have to pressure really hard. You've got 3 minutes left in lacrosse, potentially of your life. These seniors right now, they've got 3 minutes left in lacrosse unless they can make it to the next day.
Good clear.
And men's league lacrosse is nothing like MCLA lacrosse, unfortunately. It's fun, but
game is never more pure after
college.
After college.
Yeah.
Any level of college.
That's the most incredible thing to be a part of. Andrew gets it over to Big Jack.
Big Jack.
Gives a little shoulder.
Guyney gets a shot.
Oh.
Was that a save?
I don't know. I think the ball was on the ground, but Jabari almost got in there.
Ground ball.
I liked it.
For the goalie.
Yeah, we'll
Cesario here. Let's see this. Who's stopping that?
No one. He's so big.
That guy is thick.
He's so big. That's 28. That's
5 goals on the game.
I know why. He's a stud.
It's a lot of protein shakes. A
lot of protein shakes. Jack Ray with the ball. Taking it behind. He's got 2 minutes
left. Goalie. Ref in the way there. Oh, look at this finish.
There you go, 9-43.
That's a hat trick for 43. Took him long enough. We haven't seen him since the first quarter. But Kyle Collette, sophomore attack from Cincinnati, Ohio.
Andrew Galley with a nice assist there, getting some apples. They say an apple a day keeps the doctor away.
That's his 20th goal in the year.
How many assists does Andrew Galley have?
Oh, that was nine?
Nine with the assist.
Oh, nine with the assist, yep.
Does he have 15? Let me just say, not going to be a lot of doctors seeing that kid.
Yeah, he's got three assists.
Three assists today.
Solid game.
Solid game.
This offense is really fun. They've got a lot of talent.
Yeah, 90 seconds left in this match. We've got a great match going on right now.
Stick with us for after the game. We'll get, after the handshakes, we're going to get a post-game interview with the coach, and we'll pick a player. I'm thinking we're going to grab Matt Cesario.
Probably have to.
See if he's available. We're big fans of his.
It'd be irresponsible if we didn't talk to him.
Yes.
Just to get his mindset. If anyone has any good questions, send us a quick tweet, Lacrosse Leadership Institute. You've got probably 30 seconds.
Galley chasing down this ride.
Ho! 52 seconds left on the shot and game clock.
Six goal lead for Dayton.
Uh-oh.
Well, I hate to point it out, but my prediction for the fourth was that Dayton would.
I was really hoping that Kennesaw would come in and get things evened out. I thought Mitch Taylor was going to be a game changer.
And actually, none of that happened.
It didn't.
Not a single goal or an assist in the fourth quarter for Kennesaw.
It was just a really good effort by Dayton. And these guys look like they could play another quarter. Maybe not. Look at the bench over there. Those guys have their helmets off.
They're pretty gassed. Galley's over there getting a bottle of water. Oh. I hate to see that. Injury and less than a minute left.
Oh, it's brutal. Brutal. We're feeling right
That's
now
Chase
for Chase.
That's Jason Campbell being carried off the field
here. He's been working his you-know-what off.
He has 33 points on the year. Added one, two, three, four goals today.
Jeez.
Really put that team on its back,
right?
Can't
say it's not for a lack of effort.
Scored almost half his team's goals. Stopping for a shot clock correction real quick. Should be fixing the game clock too, right? But I mean, I guess 3 seconds doesn't matter.
I just think there's 17 seconds in the game. The shot clock doesn't matter.
It really doesn't.
But we will make it through the last 15 seconds of this match. I guess it does for the clear.
30 seconds.
Technically, they have one extra second.
Yeah, that's true.
And 20 seconds. Ten seconds. Five, four, three, two, one. And that's our ball game, folks. We've got Dayton 15, Kennesaw State 8, 9,
yep.
Couldn't see the fans.
Dayton will take on Rhode Island in our next round. We're stand by. We're going to get an interview with a coach and player. Again, congrats to Dayton on the first win of the 2023 National Championship. They're back to their winning ways. We'll see if this continues. Stick with us for post-game interviews.
What's coach's name? Joe and Cesario, right?
Joe Venturella.
Yeah, I'll get Cesario.
Thank you. All right, can you guys hear me? Oh, they can't hear me. Do you mind talking to them and see if they can get my mic on? Can you guys hear me now? Not yet?
Hey, can you guys hear Ryan?
Can you guys?
It's on us to stop sexual assault.
To get in the way before it happens.
To get a friend home safe.
And to not blame the victim.
It's on us.
To look out for each other.
To not look the other way.
It's on us to stand up.
For a quick post-game interview. Coach, excellent showing out there. We appreciate you. Congratulations.
Thank you.
We just wanted to ask, how are you guys feeling right now?
Feel pretty good. We were a little hesitant coming in. They're a really good team, so we weren't sure exactly what to expect, but we came to play today.
Well, I'm glad you guys did come to play. Going into this tournament, it's 4 games in 6 days. How are you guys having the guys prepare going into tomorrow?
Just trying to rotate a bunch of guys today. Try to keep them as rested as we can, keep them hydrated, get them home, get them relaxed, and then try to get as rested as possible.
Hey, well, good luck in the next matchup. We really appreciate you guys being here.
Thank you.
And now we have to bring in our leading scorer and offensive MVP, Matt. Congratulations, Cesario. Hey, what's going through your mind during a game like this?
Just coming off a tough day of travel yesterday, a little flight delay, got in pretty early this morning. Just wanted to bring the intensity today because I haven't been here at all in my 4 years. So just really grateful to be out here finally.
I absolutely love it. I think that's the right mindset, right? When we go into a big game like this, is showing up for your boys. What are you going to be talking about tonight to everyone?
Just making sure everyone hydrates, everyone gets a lot of rest, and then focuses up for tomorrow against Rhode Island.
Hey, bring that energy, man, and we're going to see a great game out of you again. Good luck, man.
Have a good one.
Take care. Hey, we appreciate everyone in the stands. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Ryan Burns, and we'll see you all in a little bit for a next round of games. Take care.
It's on us to stop sexual assault.
To get in the way before it happens.
To get a friend home safe.
And to not blame the victim.
It's on us.
To look out for each other.
To not look the other way.
It's on us to stand up.
To step in.
To take responsibility.
It's on us, all of us,
to stop sexual assault.
Learn how and take the pledge at it's on